I got this in England. How can someone maintain a pure heart when constantly being hurt by others? I understand that Allah is testing us, but sometimes it becomes overwhelming. So true. If you are 40 and above, the answer is always, been there, done that. You had enough disappointments, true? You had enough people hurt you that I was like, oh, okay, which category I'm gonna put them? This is part of life. This is why this dunya is not a place of happiness. And it's not eternity, it's temporary. But the question is, how do I keep my heart pure? Very nice question. Memorize this dua, it's from the Quran. When someone really hurts you and they are in your face, especially let's say it gets very hard when they are your member of your family. Sometimes, subhanAllah, sometimes parents, sometimes siblings, and those that you cannot, I call them non-negotiable relationships. I can't sever it. I'm not going to go to Jannah. I can't cut with my sister. I can't. But every time I see her, I'm just giving an example. May Allah save my sisters. But in general, like my sister or my brother, or sometimes parents. Parents, I mean, I have heard stories about parents. I was like, Ya Allah, what heart these parents have? Make this dua, which is actually in Surah Al-Hashr. رَبَّنَا لَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Ya Allah, do not allow my heart to have any ill feeling toward anyone, especially believers. Don't. Keep doing it. Literally, it's like when you have a dirty plate and you are washing it with a sponge and you look at the plate and says, whoa, the plate is clean. This is what this dua does. But practice it. And your intention is really, remember intention, is to keep your heart pure. I want to go to Allah with a pure heart. Then my Jannah is guaranteed. One, two. Avoid things that will bring harm to your heart. Stay away. Don't confront somebody and you know what they will say is going to be very painful. You know it. Don't put yourself in this. Very recently also somebody was telling me, right? It was a man and a woman, right? And he handed her a letter from the lawyer. And she said, subhanAllah, she said, I'm not going to read it because I don't want to have anything in my heart against you. Learn how to protect your heart. Your heart like an expensive diamond you have. Or vase, and you need to take care of it. I really mean it. So protect it. If this company that you are gonna go with, out with, you know they will affect your heart, don't go. It's very hard when you are there to protect it. It's much easier when you are away. So protect your heart. If it comes to your heart, keep making this dua. Third, another order from Allah, it's in Surah An-Nur. فَعْفُوا وَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Forgive and pardon. Don't you want Allah to forgive you? Allah said this to Sayyidina Abu Bakr when they accused Sayyidina Aisha. And he said, that's it. When he found out that it is his relative who was spreading the rumors and he used to spend on him, he said, that's it. خلاص. مصطح, no more. And Allah revealed this verse. وَلَا يَأْتَلِي أُولُّ الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَيُؤْتُوا وَأُولِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَعْفُوا وَاصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. And he was saying, those of you who have extras, money, well-to-do, do not stop paying or spending. Your relative, those who are in need, and those who migrated for the sake of Allah, and the order came in to Sayyidina Abu Bakr. Forgive and pardon. Don't you want Allah to forgive you? And immediately he said, Bala ya Rabbi. Yes, my Lord.